All right, Aki Kareem, BBTV. I'm delighted to be joined by Paul Smith, former British super middleweight champion. Your brother Callum has just landed the big one. It's a date with destiny. It's a shot at greatness against Canelo Alvarez on the 19th of December. First things first, Paul, thanks for joining me. And, you know, when you first initially were told, yeah, we've got this fight, what emotions were running through your mind?
I was literally watching Canelo Alvarez's Instagram, waiting for the decision to be announced by him, because we didn't know. I think Callum found out 5 minutes before he announced it and sent the photo of the poster through to like just the brothers group chat, just the four of us. I thought, thank God for that, because he hadn't mentioned the name yet. So I watched it happy. I think I commented with a thumbs up on Canelo's feed. But it's okay saying I've accepted, it's all done. He's accepted the fight before and he didn't get picked, he didn't get chosen, you know what I mean? He chose Billy Joe last time, so we knew there was other people in the pipeline. We knew there was probably Plant that he was speaking to and a couple of others maybe. So even watching the announcement, we wasn't so sure, but once we knew it was on, that was it, you know, then absolutely delighted for him, for Callum. He's got a brilliant chance of winning this fight. He's got the best chance out of all of them, in my opinion. People will say I'm biased, you know, I don't really care about anything like that. Just delighted for him. You know, this is a golden opportunity for Callum, even though he's the champion, even though he's Ring Magazine champion. Canelo is the face of boxing. He's the biggest name in boxing at the moment. For me, he's probably the number one pound for pound out there and has been performing at a high level, very, very high level, the elite level for a very long time, consistently as well. So, you know, my brother's got a chance to throw him.
Now, Mayweather was another guy who was known for giving his opponents a bit short notice. So he was training in the background and then making them sort of think and stew a little bit and then, boom, slamming it on them. Now, and I know you guys are very experienced, but has Callum been doing the sort of elite level preparation in the background as well, just in case he did get the nod?
I think once you're elite level, every bit of preparation that you do becomes elite. You know what I mean? He's been training hard. I know there's a difference between training for the possibility of Canelo and training for Canelo. You know, I'm not stupid saying that. I'd be lying saying that, but that's me. You know what I mean? Callum's certainly not me. Callum's been training hard, and he always keeps himself in good shape anyway, even when he's out of training. You know, I don't think he's ever seen a 14 on the scale. He's never gone out of shape. You know, so he's been training very hard. He's been sparring. He's been working well. And knowing that this date would possibly and probably happen, I think even if this date wasn't going to happen with Canelo, he would possibly fought anyway on the same date over here in the UK. So, you know, he's been training and training well. I know a couple of the lads in the gym told me the day after the announcement, Callum, I actually like the words that he used where he punched our heads in sparring. So, you know, I think he had a little bit between his teeth the following day after the announcement. Obviously, one was my brother Liam, so I won't give that away too much. But yeah, you know, Liam told me he was in the gym the following day. He was a different person. He trained very well, looked very well, looked solid, looked big, you know, looked strong and determined. And Callum, with that bit between the teeth, knowing his fight's done now, is a different kettle of fish. So, you know, I'm fully behind him 100%. I fully believe that he can do it and he's got the tools to do it.
And of course, though, it's probably the hardest fight in boxing. Canelo is the pound-for-pound king. Not only is he very precise and accurate and a good boxer, he also throws hurtful punches as well. So was there a bit of mixed emotions? You know, it's a great opportunity and you know, something that Callum can really do and strive to be great. At the same time, there's also a lot of risks involved. So was it a bit of mixed emotions as well?
No, because I know what Canelo is, and I've known long before this fight was made or before this fight was announced what Canelo is. Don't forget, we've been here before when we thought that the fight could possibly happen. There was absolutely nothing that Canelo brings that was making me think, don't go in with that fight. And Canelo was exceptional. I believe in Callum. You know, the same way when Liam got the fight announced for Canelo, there wasn't a part of me that was thinking, oh, you know, you could lose. Of course you could lose, but you can lose fighting against a journeyman in your second or third fight. You can lose against anyone. And you're fighting for British titles. Callum in his local derby for the British title, he could have lost that. Was I worried? No, not one bit. I thought Callum win and win very early and win very well, which he ended up doing. Did I think he had beat all of them? You know, even John Ryder in his last fight. Of course I did. Was I worried? You know, not really, but he could have lost and he could have been hurt in that fight. I'm not worried about this one for the same reasons. You know, I fully believe in what Callum can do. But Canelo Alvarez is, as I've said already, exceptional. I think he's very, very good at setting traps. I think he's very good at drilling himself and being drilled by his trainer, who I think is a very good trainer as well, and the same repetition after repetition until it becomes perfect, until it becomes muscle memory, until it becomes natural to you. But Callum's also got a very good coach. He's been coached very well, been trained very well from day one. Got a very good strength and conditioning side with Johnny and obviously the coach, Joe Gallagher. And he's on the ball himself, you know, and tactically, he's a very, very astute tactician and can read the fight and can judge and can also tell you a lot about what the opponent's doing. So, you know, as opposed to being worried, it's not. No, I'm not. The worst that can happen in the fight is he loses, you know, and the best that can happen is he wins. I don't tend to read in too much to that because obviously he's my brother, he's my flesh and blood, he's my family, he's my kid brother. So obviously I never want any of them to get hurt or lose, but that's boxing, but positive only. You know, this is a massive opportunity. There's a lot of experienced boxing men out there, boxing women, boxing people out there who are saying the same thing. And it's not just because they are that must mean it's right. You know, there's a lot of people out there who are happy this fight happening for boxing because it's a great fight between two very, very good fighters.
Yeah. I mean, the reaction straight away was a massive buzz from everyone to see such a great fight. You mentioned experience there. Your family is pretty much as experienced as it gets in boxing. You know, all four of you have been the British champion. You've been around boxing your whole lives. You know, Canelo is known for, as well as being a great fighter, he's known for sort of having his way, let's say, when it comes to restrictions and clauses and little things in fights. And also in fight week, the hype around him, it's all his own way. Are you going to be able to ensure that, you know, there's no little, you get the best of fair play, that is, when you go over there?
I'm sure it'll all be taken care of. Callum's got a good team around him, and he's got a good family around him. You know, as you say, it's not our first rodeo. You know, we've been in exactly the same position when Liam was fighting Canelo. Liam was champion. Liam was an unbeaten champion going in against him. Callum's an unbeaten champion going in against him. They wanted it to be Canelo Smith. Liam said, "I'm not asked. Just pay me the money. You know, whatever. I'm not bothered. If I have to walk in the ring last, I'm not bothered. You know, let's get the fight happening." Liam was fully confident, and Liam put up a great show against Canelo, in my opinion, for the light middleweight, for the super welterweight, light middleweight to box as competitively as he did. Don't forget, with not much sparring, he got cut about 3 or 4 weeks out from Kell Brook in the spar. You know, performed very well. Remember talking to Liam after the fight, he's saying, "I think if I'd have had a lot of sparring, it would have just delayed the inevitable. Maybe I would have lost on points, you know, but it was a competitive fight while it lasted." He certainly put up a very good show compared to a couple of other opponents that have fought against Canelo, and that's not a dig on it. He's just, for a light middleweight, he's as small as Liam compared to the fighters that he's gone on and boxed against, the likes of Kovalev, the likes of Field, and, you know, Jacobs and all that. Liam put up a great show. So we know what to expect with the fight week antics and everything else. And to be honest with you, there wasn't many antics from Canelo with Liam. There wasn't any, many, like, you know, foul play going on it like that. You know, the main business, that this is probably the first time at the time to do it all by themselves. But, you know, we're ready. As I say, Callum's got a good team around him, and we've been in this situation before. Going over the States, so it'll be great again. Obviously, it's always good going over there. It'll be a bit different with what's going on around the world at the minute with the pandemic. But, you know, just to answer the question you asked me a couple of questions ago regarding Mayweather, you know, this is what Canelo's like now. And you can't be like that until you be in that position to be like that. And he's in that position because he's the best fighter on the planet at the moment, considered by many as the best fighter on the planet. And then you can make the demands and you can make people dance to your beat. And that's what he's done with Callum, with everyone else. You know, he announces when he fights, he announces who he fights, and he's the ticket. And that's how boxing is. And we know that Callum could go and fight against some of the other champions, but the fight that everyone wants in that division, and the division below, and the division above, is Canelo. And, you know, Callum's got it. We've got it as a family, as a team, as a group, as a unit, you know, and Callum will maximise and capitalise on anything that he can and everything that he can. And hopefully, fingers crossed, the best Callum Smith turns up. And in my opinion, the best Callum Smith beats Canelo Alvarez.
The best Callum Smith is a formidable fighter. You know, what does he have to do that he perhaps hasn't done in previous fights, or what type of level does he need to raise to beat Canelo? And if so, you know, Canelo's got a lot of variation to his game. So has Callum. What does Callum need to do in the fight, in your eyes, without giving away too much, obviously, to go ahead and do this job?
just needs to be himself. You know, you've said it yourself. What does he need to raise it to? Callum will always raise the level to the opponent, in my opinion, but Callum's mistake in the past, as has been proven, is he'll always lower his level to his opponent as well. And he's done that in a couple of fights, and I'm not putting them down. You know, they were good, very good opponents that he was fighting against, and tough and durable and awkward in Nicky Dawson, and tough and durable and very good fight in John Ryder, who I believe has been on, you know, on a good run, even though he's fell short in a couple of his fights with decisions. There's been a couple of contested ones. You know, a lot of people contested Callum's one on the night. I didn't really have a worry. It was a closer than I liked it to the bean. But, you know, I'll sit down with anyone who wants to sit down and point out. I keep seeing Ryder by four rounds, five rounds of people who are just, you know, with all due respect, I don't think they know the boxing, but I'll happily sit down with anyone and tell them to point me out 8 rounds that John Ryder wins in that fight, or point me out even 7 rounds that win that fight. I'll break the rounds down for them with them, and I'll sit and go through. There's no way on it, in my opinion, that happens. And I don't want to get into all that, but on that night, Callum, in my opinion, you know, didn't perform, lowered his performance because of, you can't take fights as what are considered a warm-up fight, or, you know, get your mandatory out the way fight. It was a mandatory fight, and for John Ryder, it was Everton, and it was his world title shot, and it was his crack at it, and I feel for him, and I've been in that position. He'd done very well, but I don't think he'd done enough to win the fight. Callum lowered his performance against George Groves. That Callum Smith that turned up, rose to the level, rose to the occasion, made his game, and looked devastating in doing so, and winning the world title, and becoming world champion, and becoming number one in the division, and he's got that in his locker and more. We've seen what Callum can do behind closed doors. He has to perform on the night. And if anyone's going to bring a performance out, it's going to be Canelo Alvarez. He's going to bring a very good performance out to Callum, and it'll bring the best out to Callum. And the best out to Callum, in my opinion, beats Canelo Alvarez. As I've said, you know, there's an old saying, a good big one beats a good little one. And that's what I firmly believe in. I've always believed in that. And I think Callum on the day will win this fight.
I mean, he's certainly got the tools to do the job. You know, do you think, though, he's going to have to try and stop Canelo, because there's all this, you know, some of the scorecards recently that have been returned in all sorts of fights have been pretty shocking at times, to be honest. Do you think he can go over and get a decision against Canelo?
I didn't want to say this because I was sitting there saying before the Abraham fight that I had my first world title fight, sitting there saying, you know, I think they'll score it fairly. I think this guy was sort of playing devil's advocate, trying to let them know that I've marked the card early. And letting anyone know that I listen, you know what? If I do well, which I know I'm going to do well, I know he's underestimated me. I know I'm in good shape. I know I've got the tactics to beat him. The score it fairly, you know. So I'm not even getting into that. You know, I think Callum can stop Canelo Alvarez. I think he can knock him out. I think he's got the power to hit anyone from cruiserweight down to light middleweight. Obviously, Callum Smith, he's a devastating puncher. I've been hit by him myself, and all hard hits, especially to the body, but he also bangs to the head. He's a perfectionist. He's a very, very good technician. He won't throw it if it's not there. He doesn't waste much. He sets good traps himself. You know, he's got very, very long misleading leverage. We think it out the way. Misleading distance as well. Sorry, and a lot of very, very devastating leverage for someone so big, someone so tall and with long limbs that he's got. You don't expect that he can hit you. A lot of fighters want to get close and get safe, so to speak. You know, and I'm saying that in inverted commas. But it's not safe in there. That's where he wants you to be. You know, that's why he is where he is. He's number one in the world. He's world champion because he's a devastating fighter. And as I say, you know, as a brother speaking, if everything's perfect on the night, if everything's perfect in camp, which it has been so far, if everything's perfect when we get there, then he's winning that fight, and he's making a major statement on the world scene.
Well, you know, people on social media are already talking about it. Everywhere you go, every boxing forum, everywhere, everyone's talking about this fight. Now, I know what you're like on social media. You're very vocal. You're passionate about, you know, you defend your own family, and you're very vocal. Are you going to be able to sort of keep it focused when people are sort of downplaying his chances, and or is it just going to be a case of just ignoring all that sort of talk in the build-up to this one?
No, I've already seen it. Like, it's a bit difficult because, you know, as a brother, I'm delighted for my younger brother. He's got a massive opportunity, the biggest fight in boxing. And, you know, a big payday and a chance to beat Canelo Alvarez. Canelo Alvarez, guarantee your rematch, guarantee you going forward to fighting even bigger fights. And you put it on and you get someone commenting with a, you know, just a complete derogatory comment. He's going to get knocked out cold. He's going to get this. Like, oh, that's my brother. And that's me as a brother seeing that. And I think if someone was just putting, you know, I can't wait for, I don't know, you know, it's hard to describe it with other sports, you know, if Jamie Carragher's brother, when he was playing, was putting a picture on, you know, can't wait for the derby on Saturday, you know, every Tony's going to sit there and say, hope he gets his leg broke. You know what I mean? If Andy Murray's brother puts a picture of him up, you know, I can't wait for Wimbledon this month, you know, and my brother's going to win Wimbledon, I don't think anyone's going to say, hope he falls and cracks his leg or something, you know, cracks his spine. You're getting them type of messages of people, that's my brother, that's my baby brother, that's my kid brother, and what sort of reaction do you expect? You know what I mean? It's like, that's all it's there for, but, you know, I'll put a nice picture on Instagram of the post there, can't wait for this, you know, all the best, Callum, good luck, you know, go and grab your chance, seize your opportunity. There's a couple of little drugs, you know, and I go on Twitter and I put the same thing on Twitter, and it's just tweet after tweet after tweet of just fishing abuse from trolls where I just can't be asked. But I rise above it most of the time. Sometimes if I think I know them, or if I think the person is actually wanting to be respected for their opinion, then I'll sit and say something back to them, because, you know, boxing is one of them sports. It's very, very, very easy for people to infiltrate and have people think that they know a little bit without actually putting the work in and putting the miles in. You know, you put the work in, you put the miles in yourself. You know how hard this game is. You know how people are. And you get to know fighters and speak to fighters, and you know what they / we are like. You know, I still speak as a fighter, even though I'm an ex-fighter. You know, a lot of us are very approachable. A lot of us will give our time, give you know, a lot more than we receive. And it's nice to talk boxing with people, but it's like you're expecting to talk with other boxing people about it, or at least just good boxing fans who just want to know. You know, I was at the Taffy like today, and someone beat me in a wind of window down. He's like, I'm buzzing for your kid, mate. You know, he's got a good chance here. When he's going over this, that, you know, I'm laughing about, like, you know, how we're going to get into the country and whether there's going to be fans and everything else. Let's just stop the traffic lights and drive away. And that's great. You know, it's good seeing all that. The city's buzzing because of it, and people in the boxing fraternity are. But then there's people out there who are just hell bent on just being, you know, Twitter famous for 2 minutes or 5 minutes, and you know, about 15 different Twitter accounts and everything else. So, for me, the platforms on that, as you say, you know, people will always be golden. People will always be trying to get a bite, get a reaction. Me, I've never had any problem telling anyone to F off on there. You know what I mean? I've said for years, I've never offered people taxi money from Newcastle when I was biting and all. And it's just stupid. You know, I'm in the same place every day when we're not on lockdown. I'm in a Costa probably a couple of hours a day. I go to the Thunder of a night with me lad. You know, I'm not hard to find. If anyone wants to have a conversation with me, I don't mean a fight. I just mean a conversation. You know, I'll happily sit and talk with anyone. But my problem is on that social media. I sort of expect it back the way I treat people. And I wouldn't just call anyone an arsehole and start shouting at them on the street. But on there, you're meant to act like a different person. There's a phone and a screen and a couple of hundred miles between you. So, back to the subject and back to the real question, you know, yeah, it's like I'll be able to handle it all. It doesn't bother me. I'm not fighting, but, you know, if I can take a little bit of the pressure off Callum by taking half the brunt of it, then I'll happily stand in and do my job and take it. I'm big and ugly enough to do that. It doesn't bother me. Callum's just getting his head down, getting stuck into his training. Liam's training himself because he'll be having a fight probably a month later. So it's good sparring for Liam as well. You know, Callum will have to spar a couple of smaller fellas, obviously, to try and fit in towards Canals. Size, good sparring, and I'm sure Joe and Callum and all the team will think up and figure out a great game plan to try and beat Canelo Alvarez and try as the offensive way. You know, it's a big ask and it's a big job, not just for Callum, for everyone who's been in the ring with Canelo. But I think Callum's got a massive chance here, as I keep saying, and I'm not gonna change my stance on that. You know, he's got a huge chance, and I'm fully behind him, fully 100% confident that Callum Smith is going to do the job.
I remember the picture of all four of the brothers with your British title belts. It was a massive, you know, achievement for the family. How would this win compare to that? And also, should Callum go over there and do the business? How big a win is it in terms of the pantheon of British wins abroad? Is it up there with the Don Currys, you know, Lloyd Hannigan's? Is it up there with the Fury over Klitschko? Is it in that league?
Of course, it's in that league. Not just in my opinion, it'll be in most opinions, but that's not for me to say. I think, you know, that's my brother I'm talking about at the end of the day, and that's what people will say. Will I say it's a better win than Fury against Klitschko? No, I don't know. It's not for me to say. Will I say it's a better one than Hannigan or some of the other big wins abroad that we've had? You know, it's not for me to say because I'm too invested in it with him being my brother. But listen, he's the name of boxing, the face of boxing, the number one in the world, pound for pound, arguably, you know, very debatable. he's in every single top five out there. And if Callum wins and beats him, or when he wins and beats him, you know, as I'm saying, I'm fully confident in it, then that's for everyone else to say. You know, we'll just be celebrating. We'll just be busy getting together, having a great Christmas and celebrating, and then probably planning the rematch with a bit of luck. You know, as I say, it'll be some win. It'll be some achievement, and we hopefully have it with Liam. Also, there's a little bit of revenge in there. He's got a little bit for me in the past, beating George Groves. I obviously had that last to Groves, and Callum beat him, so maybe Mark 2-0.
You were caught cold a little bit in that Groves fight, weren't you? But we knew it was going to be, because you were both big punchers, dynamite punchers, and you just got caught in an exchange, didn't you? But
he's a very, very good fighter, and he went on and proved it, didn't he? Yeah, obviously, yeah. What he was capable of. It is what it is. It's boxing. He caught me. I caught him at the wrong time. He caught me at the perfect time. He won the fight. I like George. I like him as a lad. You know, I think he's very misunderstood. I've always spoke well of George Groves, and you know, I'd like to think he talked to me in the same way, because there's never been any but respect for him from myself and our family. You know, and we've had it back from him and his family. He's got a good family around him and good people around him as well. But yeah, that's just boxing. You know, but this time, obviously, with Callum Canelo, he wasn't one for Liam.
Well, look, Paul, I really appreciate you, you know, spending this time with me. I know you're a busy guy, and I really, really am fully behind Callum. I really wish you the best in training, in the lead up to it, and the camp. Hope everything goes smooth, the journey over there. I cannot wait for this fight, the 19th of December. Have you got anything to say to all Callum's sort of friends and family and all the Smith Brothers supporters out there?
He's got so many, and the lads have, you know, and it's great seeing it and seeing the support behind them. As I say, you know, I mentioned I got into a little bit too much than I should have, probably, because I don't like giving them any oxygen, to be honest with you. But, you know, the people criticising and the people trolling and having the odd little slag off here and there, it's few and far between. There's not that many. You know, the majority of the people that have been behind this fight and that are behind this fight are very behind Callum, and lovely comments, lovely praise, and he's got to just, you know, I don't even think he'll see the good, to be honest with you, all the bad. He just gets stuck into his team. He's got four massive weeks ahead of him, and the pot at the end of the rainbow, the prize at the end of the rainbow after these 4 weeks is the biggest prize out there. You know, he's already got the Ring Magazine belt. He's already world champion. He's got to keep them belts, beat this fella in front of him, and take over that role. Hopefully, you know, round about the top five of pound for pound fighters, which no one would neglect and no one would begrudge him for. The support is always great, and I just wish there could be a lot of Brits going over there. But even though I think they'll be allowing fans in there, I don't think any Brits will get in the country because of COVID, the way it's going at the moment. So, you know, fingers crossed even more for a Callum Smith win, so we can get a rematch maybe back at Anfield at the end of May, 2021.
That will be something. That will be something. Paul, thank you so much for joining me, mate. All the best.
No problem. Thanks for having me, Aki. Cheers.
Take care, mate. See you later. Appreciate it.
Take care. All the best. No problem.